go the full distance.
So even if we weren't talking superheroes, this would still be busted. Because when the car's cut in half, it doesn't run for very long.
Yeah, some might say that's because someone drove it directly into a wall.
Details!
All right, well, I guess that's one way of saying our test came to an abrupt ending. But, I mean, let's face it, we put fuel in the lines, and I had to use starter fluid in the carburetor to even get the car going.
True, but the superhero in me would like to remind you that Cato knew this car was going to be cut in half all along, so he put a reserve fuel tank in the front of the car, so when our car is cut in half, no fuel lines were actually cut in the first place.
In which case, we need to modify our half car and see if we can make it run for longer.
Okay, so Seth is stretching, but it's a legitimate test. If the half car had the fuel, could it drive for long enough to make a superhero-style getaway? To find out, the team hits the Petaluma Speedway. And with a couple of laps under their belts, they're ready to prep their ride. Just as Seth suggested his superhero sidekick Cato did, they're adding a reserve fuel tank in the front.
Without fuel, you don't go anywhere.
But even with fuel, will they go anywhere? Will their half car be able to overcome the friction caused by the drag of the undercarriage? And will the compromised structure remain intact for any kind of distance?
I think it'll make it three laps.
Man, I would be happy if it made it one.
Dude, I think five.
Yeah? Let's go.
All right, let's try. Eat my dust.
Earth like a kitten.
This is half car drag race. In three, two, one, go! Get it? Drag race?
That's a promising start, and somewhat unexpected because despite a safe, steady speed on the first lap...
He's maintaining about 20 right now.
Tori is clearly having no problems at all. Not what the team thought before they started.
Picking up speed. He's up to 30.
And lap one!
When Tori first started out, he started out slow because, let's face it, this is the first time we've ever driven a car that's been cut in half. And so his laps were maybe 10, 15 miles an hour. Once he started getting the hang of driving it, he punched it. And on the straightaways, he peaked out at over 40 miles an hour.
I cannot believe how fast and how well this car drives. I mean, the handling's a little tricky. It's kind of like driving on a wet road or maybe an icy road.
And exceeding all three team members' expectations by a factor of at least four, Tori completed 20 laps without a problem.
Yeah! That was crazy!
That's 20 laps at 40 miles an hour, and the car was sparking like it was catching on fire.
Oh, that was great. No problems at all.
Half car altered? Plausible.
Totally plausible. Oh, if the Black Beauty had a reserve fuel tank and if it had separate brake lines, yeah.
Hey,
that was awesome.
Jump down, Cato.
Good job. That was awesome. Oh, my God. I can keep going.
So it's plausible. You can drive half a car. But what about the myth as a whole? For that wrap, it's back to the show.
Yeah, I think we've done enough damage here.
All right, so how are we going to wrap this one?
I think we're going to have to call this one busted.
Whoa, 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 whoa. I think I saw a different show than you guys.
We were not able to cut a car in half with an elevator.
The car has a zipper thing in it. It cuts itself in half.
All right, what about the fuel line?
He put it all in the front. He knew.
Okay. In the perfect superhero world, if the Black Beauty happened to be a front-wheel drive, unlike anything of the era, and the gas tank were in the front, and the brakes were in the front, and it could get cut in half by an elevator, sure, it's totally plausible.
Plausible?
Nope. So it's confirmed.
Don't press your luck.
Okay, I'll take plausible.